How to objectively assess the maneuverability of a board and compare it to another board. We have in Shaper Wave Dynamics a hydrodynamic scanner which allows us to edit a diagram of the hydrodynamic performance of the board. We will see how to edit this diagram. For a given board, we are going to select from the library, for example a longboard. So we import a longboard and simply go to the Shaper Report menu to edit the performance scan. In the Shaper Report, the performance scan is edited according to three speeds, which we will choose. By default, we have 15, 25, and 33 kilometers per hour, which correspond to the different crest speeds, for wave heights. From 40 centimeters to 3 meters. So that will give us a good idea of how this board performs in different waves. We will be able to see if this shape and this size of board is appropriate for this surfer with a given weight in a given wave condition. So here I am going to edit the hydrodynamic scan. Here is our hydrodynamic scan for this longboard, displayed in the Shaper Report. In the Shaper Report, three tabs have been added: Hydro Scan, Angles of Attack. In fact, we see here in these three diagrams at the three speeds of 15, 25, and 33 km per hour, the different variations of angles of attack according to the surface position on the board. What will interest us particularly is the variation of the angle of incidence when the surfer moves from the back to the front of the board on the center line. Here, we see that the angle of attack is 8 degrees when the surfer advances 1250 millimeters from the tail, i.e. a little in front of the board, and that this angle of attack increases up to 38 degrees. When the surfer moves back up to 300 millimeters from the tail, all the white areas around that are not colored are the areas of instability. If the surfer exceeds these colored zones, he is in situations of imbalance and falling. Example, if it goes too far forward, it will push the nose. If it goes too far to the side, it will generate a tilt, which no longer allows the surfer to be carried at that speed. And if he goes too far back, there won't be enough lift to carry the surfer at that speed. So the colored zone shows the safest possible balance zone at this speed of 15 km per hour. And we see in these three diagrams this zone of balance evolving according to the speeds. When we go up in speed, we will reach 4.6 degrees. We're going to lower the minimum angle of incidence. We also note one thing, it is the pitch stab length. It is length of stability in pitch. The surfer will be able to move from the rear area to the front area over approximately 1250 millimeters without imbalance. When we say the surfer moves, we are talking about his center of gravity. We don't care where his feet are. The important thing, and what we see here, is the areas where the center of gravity moves. So we see here that the pitch stability zone for this longboard at low speed is 1250 millimeters long. It goes to a length of 1400 millimeters when increasing the speed. Because the water hardens, increased dynamic pressure, we have a greater zone of stability. So here, we will be able to study the effects of different positions on the angle of incidence. And so this diagram is the hydro scan of the angles of attack. In this other tab, we have hydro scan of the drag. Drag is the force of resistance to progress. If we have less drag than propulsive force, we accelerate. If we have more drag than propulsion, we brake. So here, we see it changing the positions of the surfer, from the back to the front, and we observe a maximum drag in the rear position, of 36 kilos, approximately 364 newtons, whereas a forward position does not generate more than a drag of 74 newtons. We also find that this drag is separated into two components. Frictional drag is the friction on the hull of the board, and planing drag, resulting from the deformation of the water flow, generated by the change in momentum of the relative flow. And these two drags add up to make the overall drag. It is interesting to separate these two drags, because the drags of friction, and of planing, do not evolve in the same way with the speed. So that's it for the hydro scan schematics. We are going to move on to another hydro scan scheme, which is interesting for the shaper and the surfer. It is the hydro scan of the radii of curvature, and of the lateral stability. So here we see the three lateral stability patterns with a speed of 15, 25, and 33 km per hour, always with a surfer of the same size, 80 kilos. We have a 3-meter board with a width of 632 millimeters. Information on the detail board is always recalled. We see here that, at low speed, we have a zone of stability, which is quite narrow, and at high speed, we have a zone of stability that is quite wide. We measure this zone of stability. Here the stability of roll has a width of 252 millimeters, i.e. we will be able to move. Therefore move our center of gravity by 252 millimeters without falling. And when we go to see the stability zone at 33 kilometers per hour, we see that it has increased to 380 millimeters. As you gain speed, the board increases in stability. The difficulty of going from rail to rail increases. With speed, it becomes more difficult to apply roll, and to make the board change direction. So we see here the variation of the maximum radius of curvature, determined by the maximum roll inclination, here 72 degrees, 75 degrees at 25 kilometers per hour, and 75 degrees at 33 kilometers per hour. We see that the radii of curvature, therefore 0.6 meters, i.e. very radical. Here, with a little more speed, we will reach radii of curvature of 1.2 meters at 75 degrees. And we show here that 33 kilometers per hour ago, we have a radius of curvature of 2.3 meters, with a roll angle of 75 degrees. So there too, in very tight radiuses, with the surfer pressing hard on his board. But what interests us is to see the width of this zone of stability. We note that the radius of curvature is approximately 2.3 meters, whereas it was 6 meters. We see that the radius of curvature tends to increase with speed. It is more difficult to turn at high speeds than at low speeds. So that's it for these three hydrodynamic scans, for the longboard. So it gives us numbers, but it doesn't provide a lot of information, in terms of sensations, because it's still numbers. What is really interesting is to compare one board to another. Here we have a longboard. I can compare it, by doing the same series of hydrodynamic scans, with a short board. I'm taking my default short board here, and dragging it into my project. But I could also draw and scan the board I'm using to surf, and edit its hydro scan. We can therefore compare a board that we know well in terms of surfing, with another board that I do not know, and observe how the stability, the radius of curvature, or the drag has been modified, compared to what I know. So we will be able to make an objective comparison between a new project and a known board. So here on the short board, I am republishing my shaper report. To access the shaper report, if it is no longer visible, click on shaper report at the top with the indication of the current number of pages. So here, three new tabs have been added to my shaper report. These are the performances of my short board. Here we have the performance of the long board. Here we have the performance of the short board. I will observe the performance, in terms of radius of curvature, of my long board, and note, that here at a speed of 33 km per hour, I have 2.3 meters of radius of curvature on my long board. and stability 380 millimeters. I'm going to use the same pattern, but on my shortboard, and I went from 380 to 292 millimeters in terms of stability width, so it's a board that is a little less stable in turns. And we see, on the other hand, that its radius of curvature is reduced to 1.80 meters, whereas for the longboard, the radius was 2.30 meters. Obviously, it's a board that will be easier to turn and make tighter turns. We will also be able to compare the different drags and the different angles of attack for my two projects. We are not going to go into the detailed analysis of the hydrodynamics of these boards here. But we can clearly see that we have here a very powerful and very objective tool for comparing hydrodynamic phenomena for two given boards. We could edit that for a different weight surfer or do a modification on a board to seek greater or lesser stability or a higher drag or lower depending on the project. It can sometimes be useful to have an increasing drag. For example, if I'm doing a drag hydro scan, the braking capacity of a board is given by its maximum drag here. If I modify the back of this board, I will modify the maximum drag, and therefore its braking capacity. So by modifying the shape of the board, by re-editing hydrodynamic scans, I will see how the position of the surfer changes the performance of the board. We are thus going to carry out a complete, objective, and well-argued analysis of our shape. The hydrodynamic scan makes the hydrodynamics of the shape accessible to the surfer and the shaper. That's it for this hydro scan tutorial with shaper wave dynamics.